So I think I'm gonna do Year of the Snake. Since I beat the game, this is supposed to take place after. And this is like a horror story with Jiangshi, like the hopping Chinese vampires. Interesting. Yeah, I guess so. All right.
Good to see you, A.
I got a call. Something about an urgent problem in the New Year celebrations?
Yeah, about that. Seems you made a lot of bosses unhappy lately, so...
Are you serious?
Look, I can't ignore a direct order just because I think it's wrong.
Come on.
And neither can you.
Wait, so I'm in purgatory now, is that it? Punishment for my sins?
You upset a lot of people. Let's not even get into the property damage out there. Or the total carnage that seems to follow you everywhere you go. Bosses aren't happy.
Screw them. I'm a cop. You gonna put me out on the street or not?
In a manner of speaking.
So action hero-y. Reminds me of something out of like the last action hero. Sweet.
This sucks. Holy shit. Stop, police! Suspect is in a blue vehicle. License 12X448.
448 must be a rental.
Seen a guy in yellow.
He went that way.
You seen a guy in a yellow shirt?
I think he's there.
Stop, police! In pursuit of suspect.
You can't stop us. It's horrible.
What?
I saw a guy hiding over there.
Thanks. I'll take it from here.
Did you see that shit? I accidentally arrested that lady.
What were you up to? Son of a bitch. Dispatch, I have a bomb here. I repeat, I have a bomb.
Stand by, don't touch it. Wait for the bomb squad.
What? No time, dispatch. This thing's gonna go off.
That's a direct order.
Yeah, well, it's a stupid order. I'm running it into the bay.
What? Are you crazy?
This thing might blow up half the neighborhood.
Officer Shen, where are you?
Almost there. Almost. Dispatch, this is Shen.
Where's the car?
At the bottom of the ocean. Negative, dispatch. I need to follow up. You have an address on that license plate?
Who ever heard of a plate with 2-4s in it?
You got an address?
Stand by.
Hong Kong police!
It's 322 Sa Ching Road, but the boss won't be happy.
When are they ever?
Import Mobile. 現在就來看看我們的最新優惠價和所有你最喜歡的牌子 Import Mobile 全城至底價
What is this place? What is this shit? This just gets weirder and weirder. These guys are fucking crazy.
It's that cop! The fucker that followed Wu! Get him!
Holy shit! Crazy bastards. You're looking at 10 years minimum.
These guys have some nice studs.
I don't see a guy with the balls to do that kind of time.
I like 10 days. None of us will.
What's that mean?
When the new year starts, it's all over. So your prisons, your laws, they don't mean anything to me.
What's over? What happens on New Year's?
The world, it ends.
How do you mean ends?
Master Chu teaches when the year of the snake begins, the world will end. All of its creatures will be divided into two groups. Those who helped usher in the great reckoning will feast in heaven alongside the great master himself. The unbelievers will be cast down into hell.
Let me get this straight.
Where is this Master Chu now?
I don't know. He's helping. We're all helping.
How many helpers are there?
Hundreds. We're his army.
Son of a bitch.
I'm gonna kill your dad. Piss on his grave. That's right.
睇你個死樣啊，弱智仔！
Leave me alone!
The guy stole my wallet!
Oh, shit. Just what I needed. Stop! Police!
The whole city is blowing up. Where the hell did you find time to bust me? What kind of priorities is that?
You're under arrest for being too pretty. Onward.
Hong Kong police!
Watch where the fuck you're going!
Is it, whoa, that guy's missing an arm.
Back the fuck off.
Man, and I took his bike. That guy is missing an arm too. Two one-armed guys on the same street. God, must be factory workers. God. Well, that guy's missing an arm too. What's going on? Why are everybody losing their right arm? Is it the right arm or left arm? Jackie. Poor Jackie. He never even knew.
Come, look. I fixed you up.
I didn't even know what he's trying to talk.
We've learned that our guys are going to buy something from a dealer out there. Find out what he's selling.
I'm on it.
It's
Serve it up.
Thanks, Wade. Enjoy.
Sneezes.
Central, I'm at the K-Bar.
Yeah, I'm sure I'm going to hear a lot of conversations in here.
Yellow, obviously. Give me one dark one, and one that's chocolatey. And one that's really white. I mean, whiter than white. And a red one.
Hey, Daddy!
How's my little girl?
She's good. She's feeling nice and full.
Enjoyed her lunch?
You know she did. She's really looking forward to her dinner.
I'll bet. And her dessert.
Oh, you're naughty, Danny. You know I'm a little nervous about dessert.
I like it when you are. Makes it more tasty.
Is it going to be big?
You know it is.
Now I'm going to be scared all day. I won't be able to sit still.
Where's who?
The guy's waiting for us in the back. I don't know, but he's back there waiting for us. We should go talk to him.
Not without who. I don't hear nothing without who.
But he's back there. He's just hanging around.
Don't care. I want to wait for who.
What if he doesn't wait for us?
You think he's going to build farms for someone else?
You the guy?
Meet me outside.
Oh. I fucked up their shit. Didn't mean to, but it happened. I got places to be. I can't be standing back and apologizing because the mood's already broken. I can't fix what's been broken. I've been on this rooftop before.
Yeah.
change the data. Well, how can I? Jump the gate? Okay. This way. Clearly. Don't want to miss that evidence bag.
Stop!
You can't jump on the roof of that. I've tried before. You glitch the fuck out.
Yes!
Oh,
thank
shit.
You, Wayne! I knew I could count on you!
That's a stupid superstition. Nobody really believes it.
Freeze!
I'm gonna arrest this guy first. Whoa. He only has one arm. I wonder how that'll go. Oh. Interesting. So I handcuffed his phantom limb. That's okay. I'm booking you. Oh, I got a comment. What's this? Pull up in my phone.
How many bombs have you sold them? Just one. What do they want it for?
They're gonna blow up the Chain Shot Road when it's full of people.
Just one. What do they want?
Hey, Emery. How's it going, buddy? Finished the story, so now I'm playing through the expansion pack. There, fixed it. Ralph Mundo, that's my name, don't wear it out. Explode. You and me. What a good team. Ever play a Sora's Wrath? I did. A while back. Funny enough, I returned it. But I may have just needed the money. I don't know. I don't remember it captivating me, though. However, I've always thought about giving it a second chance. I've given Dark Souls 2 many chances, and I'm not even sure that it is deserving of so. But, I don't know, maybe one day I'll love it, just like how I watched so much Roseanne, I eventually grew to love Roseanne, the television show. That show has, like, such a downer ending. The only one that's worse is Dinosaurs. Oh, Zora's Wrath is the only DLC you ever bought. You loved it. I'll have to give it another shot. It was kind of expensive when I bought it. I bought it used or whatever. And either I wanted to play something else, or I needed the money, something. But I do not have it anymore. No, not. Well, maybe the woman, but I was. I was talking about the television show with John Goodman and Johnny Galecki and that blonde from Scrubs, but she was the one who replaced the original daughter, who was a lot better. And I forget the cousin's name. They called her Jackie, but she's been in a lot of stuff. She's pretty good. Physically and carnally, I mean, I don't know. She's going blind, you know that? That's
wait,
a shame.
Cultists have been reported along the Qingsha Road. Multiple bomb threats reported.
I don't know how much time Roseanne has left. But that was a really well-written TV show ahead of its time. And a lot of people went on to have fairly successful television careers after that, especially Johnny Galecki, who's like one of the main guys of the Big Bang Theory. Did I see 10 Cloverfield Lane? I did not. Why was it? Was it worth seeing? I did it. Damn, that was my last sip of water. I should have prepared better. Oh crap. No, I don't want the fucking cab. I just wanted him to drive me. Oh, here's one. Oh, John Goodman's in it. Yeah, John Goodman's a great actor. He was, like, the best part of Roseanne. Did you know that, I believe it's the last season of Roseanne, is just Roseanne writing? Because John Goodman, Dan, built her own, like, little writer's thing with a typewriter in the shed. Because they couldn't afford blah, 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 and Roseanne wanted to be a writer. And he has a heart attack at the end of one of the seasons, and he recovers, and then they win the lottery, and then the whole season is them being, like, really rich, and Roseanne teaching rich people how to suck less and be more down to earth, and her Roseanne charm, if you want to call it that. And then it's revealed on the last episode that John Goodman actually died of a heart attack. Dan.
Where is it? Come on. Where is it? I don't even know what the damn thing looks like.
But yeah, he died. He died of a heart attack, and she's like riding in her shed at the end of it.
Wait, there you are.
And that's how the last episode ends. It's pretty awesome. I have a lot of love, appreciation, respect. Respect's a good word. I have a lot of respect for that show.
Your world is going to end ahead of schedule.
Because, I don't know, I wouldn't go out of my way to watch it. Maybe certain episodes. There's some really good standout episodes. And they had a lot of really cool, reoccurring cast members. And, I think George Clooney was, like, on that show for a while, if I remember right. It ran for fucking ever, too. But I'd say it's up there with, being one of the most subversive sitcoms of its time, including, like, Seinfeld. Because they did a lot of shit in Roseanne that most other sitcoms would have struggled to get away with. So in a way, it was like a trendsetter. It helped raise the bar on what's acceptable on television. I mean, I recall it being a big deal that she said crap so much.
Crap. I don't need your crap, Dan.
But I don't know, I wouldn't necessarily go out of my way to watch it. So, is she delusional or damn in heaven or hell? I liked subversive stuff, but now everything feels subverted, so I watch Andy Griffith. I mean, that's a good show. Another good one is Golden Girls. Oh. Whoa, that was incredible. I wasn't paying attention, and that was well worth it. Did you see how he exploded? Just like... yeah, I've watched some Andy Griffith lately. My grandmother likes Golden Girls, so I've seen just about every episode. That's a pretty good show. Again, like, I think it got away with a lot because it's like, oh, old ladies, but, like, some of the stuff they say, and get away with in that show, it's crazy. And like, Bea Arthur is really fucking funny. They have a really good cast. Rue McCallahan, Sophie is, I think, just the character's name, and then you have, Betty White as Rose. Yeah, that's a good show. Andy Griffith is good too. Don Knox is pretty funny.
Move, you morons!
Green Acres is the place.
Where's the bomb squad?
Gilligan's Island. Ooh, yeah, I should probably run the whole time, not briskly jog with a bomb. Fun fact, those characters in Chinese, Nishur, or Nisula, which is you dead, and then like, what do you call it, particle, shit. Late. Leave it in my beaver. Leave it to beavers, alright. All classics, you know, Brady Bunch, Silver Spoons, The Jeffersons, which was a nice spinoff. Facts of Life. I mean, all those are classics. I mean, I watched most of those same place I watched Roseanne, which is on Nick at Night. Growing up. Oh, Mr. Ed. I skipped Mr. Ed. Yeah. And, what's his face? Died recently. Alan Young. Is that his name? He also was Scrooge McDuck. God rest his soul.
Hong Kong Police!
Archie Bunker was prophetic. And then there's Family Matters. Married with Children. Those are all good. I like Modern Family. I think that show's pretty fun. Pretty witty writing. I'm a little surprised how long it's run, but I think the format has something to do with it. With the mockumentary sort of style, but it's weird because it never really addressed camera crews at all in the show. Unlike The Office, where it's like every once in a while it reminds you it's a crew, but this almost feels more like, I don't even know, like it's imaginary. Like but other, I mean, it's,
hello, I'm not doing anything wrong.
Grandfathered got canceled because I think that show was better than Modern Family, or was at least pretty close in quality. You know, I guess there's a difference between like a show that's run for like, God, I hate to think how long Modern Family has been running. Maybe 10 years? It couldn't be.
Get it off me! Get it off!
Oh, I should get away from the cultists? And, what was the other one that got canceled? My parents like Castle, I like Castle. I would watch that with them sometimes. And they like, what was that show with Rob Lowe and Ben Savage? That show wasn't bad either, I thought. The Closer. That got canned. There's a handful of shows that I thought were fairly decent, but I loved Grandfathered. Like, Fuller House came out, but it felt, I don't know, it wasn't quite as good as Grandfathered, because they brought in people from, like, well, they brought in Bob Saget and, Joey What's-His-Face, Gladstone. On Grandfathered for cameos, and that was pretty dope. They also got Drake from Drake and Josh on. So it was cool to see, like, a little bit of appreciation from where these guys came from. And they left it on a cliffhanger, which was probably a bad move if they didn't know they were gonna get renewed. But, I guess it works as an ending. Just kind of a somber note. Nothing positive. It basically ends with John Stamos sat in the rain. Fuller House was subversive, not family friendly. Sad. You think so? I watched it in Chinese with subtitles, so I actually kind of forget a lot of what happened in that show. I didn't like it that much, but I didn't find it any more subversive than, like, the original Full House. Though I think the writing in Full House was a lot better, and it had, like, a full cast rather than, like, a fraction of, like, the original cast, and replaced by these weird Disney Channel rejects. No offense. And banking mostly on cameos rather than, you know, creating something of its own. I mean, it's a nice nostalgia piece, but and I'm glad it exists. I'll say that too, but I don't know. It you ain't gonna get the same thing, because we live in a different era. Just like you're not gonna get a movie that feels like something from the 1980s without it, like, purposely trying to. Yeah, I think he did. I would not be surprised. You know how dirty of a comic Bob Saget was, and they would, I'm sure there's probably some sort of YouTube compilation or some shit out there, but, you know, they'd hide as much as they could in that show, because it all started off as just a smart-ass parody of the genre.
Hong Kong police.
And kind of like the Talking Heads, who were making fun of New Wave, it became, like, super successful, and after a while, like, the pigs became the men, you know what I mean? Nonetheless, good show. Also, another lame thing about Fuller House is the several Fuller House. Let me enunciate that. The several jabs at the Olsons, which is cool and all. You can do that, but I do feel like they captured the format really well. Like it does feel like something, you know, from 20 years ago as far as like pacing, the laugh tracks. I think they said that it was shot in front of a studio audience, so I guess not laugh track, but live studio audience. You know, the multi-angle TV set. Like, Modern Family and Grandfather, and most modern, well, most, like, hey, TVs on the air, like, single camera.
We got a bomb threat. I'm checking the vehicles. I doubt there's anything to it. Who'd want to trash cars like these? But better be safe than sorry.
Unless it's by the what's-his-face, who does, you know, like, Big Bang Theory and, Two and a Half Men, wrote the Ninja Turtles theme song. I always forget his name. He's like the sitcom king. And then there's Dan Schneider, like, the schlocky kid sitcom king on Nickelodeon. Which I've been watching some of his show, Game Chasers, because Kel Mitchell's on it. Jabs at Trump in the first episode. Yeah, and I'm pretty sure that they were 80-yard in. As in, you know, they dub them in later, and that's, I'm pretty sure, I recall pointing those out. You know. It's just kind of lame. Simpsons does it all the time. I'd say almost every episode Simpsons has something that they change a punchline of a joke and the mouth sync is off. But it's bad when you do it with live action shit. I guess because it's studio audience, they have to do, what do you call it? That's why they have to do the ADR and not do a reshoot. You know. And I can only wonder what they replace. They must have been pretty shitty jokes to just do a Trump joke, because that's lazy writing. So it tells me to check the cars for anything suspicious. These cars? This one has snakes on it. I guess I'll get in it. Okay. I guess not. There's like a fuck ton of folders around here.
Holy shit! Must be remote control! Take my bike! Get that car back!
Overall, I found Fuller House to be pretty disposable. I liked, what do you call it? The Unbreakable Kimmy Schmidt. I think that show's alright. But I think it's mostly carried by the actress. And I like fish out of water scenarios. Some of the writing's a little cheap, kind of boring, repetitive Asian stereotype, gay stereotype. While not like necessarily projected in a negative light, it's just kind of obnoxious. I would say the humor does not. I would say the obnoxiousness outweighs the humorous aspects. And they try to in the second season, I think, have those characters grow a little bit more, so they're less one-dimensional. but it's, again, just fairly disposable show, I think. I gotta go across the city again. Just start hitting him. But yeah, I mean, I liked, as far as like Netflix has had to offer, Orange is the New Black was really good, though I feel like it's really drawn out. I feel like it should have ended already. I don't know why there's another season other than it being like really successful. I feel like it's already played its part. I enjoy Schitt's Creek. Well, I do too.